Over 500 residents at Buyiri village in Bujumbura sub-county in Kalangala district are grappling with lack of electricity, which is hindering their ability to engage in different economic activities such as welding, knitting, bars, among others. Ronald Tebusweke, a businessman who once owned an electric sewing machine, turned into a manual machine, thus slowing his ability to produce enough clothes needed by the community. Not because I am disabled, but due to lack of power. If I had power, I would have just staffed and produced quality work swiftly, and I also have the ability to use different machines. But without power, we are limited to use different machines. People can't consume cold drinks. Development is difficult. Some of us have lodges, but we fear to use tadobas, and we resort to candles. But if we are connected to power, our lodges could go up to 5,000. Darkness would become a dream, as well as boosting development in our area. Though power has been supplied to 50 villages of Kalangala on Bugala Island, with consuming population of 5,190 clients, Buyiri Learning Site, which harbors over 500 residents, was left out. Ashraf Kasule, the learning site chairperson, appealed to government to avail them with free connection in order to help them lift their livelihoods.
But another place center for in Kalanga, because we have to, is in Chamsua. It completely has no electricity, but it's supposed to perform the same duties that are in this.
Yeah, we feel that we cannot pay anymore for these tariffs. What can we do? How can we go about that? Is there any possible process we can do?
In a bid to enhance power supply on the island, the government of Uganda through the Ministry of Energy embarked on installation of a fast submarine cable to connect Bugala Island to the national main grid, which will see these power problems solved on the island. Andrew Kilama Rajul, the Kalangala Infrastructure Service Limited officer, says the current challenges in power include a programmed load shedding, which will end immediately after installation of the submarine cable.
In the workshop, is that after midnight demand significantly drop, and yet the cost of producing power at that time is the same with the production cost during the day. So that makes it very unprofitable to operate after midnight. And we made a conscious decision to do this load shedding.
He further said that after the installation of this submarine cable, the supply of power will significantly change on the island, where tariffs will be lowered, as well as elimination of constant load shedding.
Cost reduces. We hope that we'll be in position like pre-COVID time to be able to provide power 24/7. But in the event that the marine cable come on stream, then the dynamics again would have changed significantly, because we will have a relatively cheaper power from the main land.
Story compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news in Kalangala.